एनसीईआरटी साइंस क्लास 8 चैप्टर 3 फोर्स एंड प्रेशर मॉड्यूल 4। हेलो फ्रेंड्स, इन द प्रीवियस मॉड्यूल वी स्टडीड इन डिटेल अबाउट नॉन कॉन्टैक्ट फोर्सेस, मैग्नेटिक फोर्स, इलेक्ट्रोस्टैटिक फोर्स एंड ग्रेविटेशनल फोर्स आर एग्जांपल्स ऑफ नॉन कॉन्टैक्ट फोर्सेस। वी ऑल्सो स्टडीड द टू फैक्टर्स ऑन विच द प्रेशर डिपेंड्स, the magnitude of force applied and the area over which the force is applied. Let us now study the concept of pressure. What is pressure now? We have seen in the activities that a force is to be applied on an object and its effect is on the area of contact. So force acting on a unit area of the object is measured by a physical quantity called pressure. So what is pressure? Pressure is the force acting on a unit area of the object. Is it clear? What is pressure? Pressure is the force acting on a unit area of the object. If P is the pressure, F is the force, and A is the area of contact, then pressure P will be equal to what? Force F divided by area A. So force per unit area is nothing but pressure. We have studied greater is the force, greater is the pressure. And greater is the area of contact, lesser is the pressure. So pressure is what? The force acting on a unit area of the object. Force per unit area is pressure. What is the standard unit of measuring force? We know that the standard unit of measuring force is Newton. What is the standard unit of measuring area? The standard unit of measuring area is square meter or meter square. So what is the standard unit of measuring pressure? We know pressure is what? Force per unit area. So SI unit of pressure will be equal to what? SI unit of force divided by SI unit of area. What is the SI unit of force? Newton. What is the SI unit of area? Meter square. So the SI unit of pressure will be Newton per meter square. What is the standard unit of measuring pressure? The standard unit of measuring pressure is Newton per square meter. This is also called Pascal. It is known as what? Pascal. So the standard unit of measuring pressure is also called Pascal after the great scientist. So what is the standard unit of measuring pressure? Newton per square meter or Newton per meter square or even called Pascal. Is the concept of pressure now clear to you? Let us do some numericals based on the concept of pressure. Numerical 1. A solid object weighs 200 Newton. When placed on a wooden plank, the area of contact is found to be 5 meter square. Find the pressure exerted by the solid object on the wooden plank. Read the numerical 2-3 times. Try to write what is given in the numerical. Also write what is to be calculated in the numerical. We have a solid object weighing 200 Newton. It is placed on a wooden plank. The area of contact of this solid object is 5 meter square. We have to calculate the pressure exerted by the solid object on the wooden plank. So what is given in the numerical? Force. Force F is how much? 200 Newton. What is the area of contact A? 5 meter square. We know the formula of pressure is what? Force per unit area. Force divided by area. So we can say pressure P is equal to force F divided by area A. What is force given? 200 Newton. What is the area of contact? 5 meter square. Dividing 200 by 5, we get 40. So the pressure is 40 Newton per meter square or 40 Pascals. So we get the answer, the pressure of 40 Newton per meter square or 40 Pascals is exerted by the solid object on the wooden plank. See how easy it is to solve a numerical if our concepts are very clear and we are applying the right formula. Let us do numerical 2. A brick is 30 cm long, 10 cm wide and 10 cm thick. It weighs 24 Newton and is lying on the ground. Find the pressure exerted by the brick on the ground. Read the numerical 2-3 times. Write what is given in the numerical. Also write what is to be calculated in the numerical. What is given in the numerical? A brick which is applying a force of 24 Newton. The area of contact of the brick is given by the area of rectangle length into breadth. Length is 30 cm and breadth is 10 cm. So the area of contact is 30 cm into 10 cm. Now the area to be calculated in this case has to be in terms of meter. So we convert 30 cm and 10 cm into meter. And how can we convert centimeter into meter? By dividing by 100. As we know, 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter. So dividing by 100, 30 centimeter is equal to 0.3 meter and 10 centimeter is equal to 0.1 meter. So the area of the brick is 0.3 meter into 0.1 meter and that is equal to 0.03 meter square. So what is the area of the brick? 0.03 meter square. We have to calculate in this numerical the pressure exerted by the brick on the ground. What is the formula of pressure? Pressure P is equal to force F divided by area A, because pressure is force per unit area. So to calculate pressure P, what is the force? 24 Newton. What is the area? 0.03 meter square. So we can write P is equal to 24 Newton divided by 0.03 meter square. Dividing 24 by 0.03, we will get 800. So the pressure exerted by the brick on the ground is 800 Newton per meter square. Or we can also write 800 Pascals. I am sure you will find to solve all numericals easy if you know the concepts and you are able to apply the right formula. Let us now study applications of pressure. Applications of pressure. A heavy truck is fitted with 6 to 14 tires. Give reason. If you see a heavy truck moving on the road, it has 6 to 14 tires. Why? The reason is, these tires increases the area of contact on which their weight acts. Because of the increase in area of contact, the pressure of the heavy truck on the ground decreases. So here, this tires increases the area of contact on which their weight acts and hence reducing their pressure on the ground. With the result, the heavy truck does not sink into the road. Is it clear or not? One more example. Application of pressure. You must have gone to the hilly areas which is covered with snow during the winters. You must have seen there the skiers sliding over the snow. What are they wearing? Skiers use long flat skis to slide over snow. The skis have a large area of contact. Why? Because this is very important to reduce the pressure of their weight on the snow. The skis have a large area of contact which reduces the pressure on the snow and enable the skiers to slide over the snow without sinking in the snow. So in this way, they are able to comfortably slide over the snow without sinking in the snow. So what do the skiers wear? They wear long flat skis to slide over the snow. Is it clear? One more example. If you look at the knives, blades, axes, etc., the cutting edges of knives, blades, axes, etc. are sharp. Why they are sharp? The cutting edges of the knives, blades, axes, etc. are sharp, due to which the area of contact decreases. When the area of contact decreases, the pressure exerted by them increases. This large pressure will help to cut the objects easily. That is why sharpened objects increases pressure and helps to cut the objects easily. One more example. Foundations of high-rise buildings are kept wide. Why? Foundations of high-rise buildings are kept wide so that the weight of the building may fall over large area of the ground. We have just studied that pressure is inversely proportional to the area of contact. Larger is the area of contact, lesser is the pressure exerted. Since here, what we have seen, the weight of the building fall over large area of the ground. So they exert less pressure on the ground and do not sink in due to the extremely high pressure of the building. So high-rise building having extremely high pressure does not sink into the ground because the foundations of high-rise building are kept wide so that the weight of the building may fall over large area of the ground. Is it clear or not? One more application of pressure. If you look at your school bag, a school bag has wide straps made up of thick cloth, canvas. Why so? A school bag has wide straps made up of thick cloth, canvas, so that the weight of the bag may fall over a large area on the shoulder of the child. What will happen if the school bag has wide straps? The weight of the bag may fall over a large area of the shoulder of the child. And we just studied that pressure is inversely proportional to the area of contact. Larger is the area of contact, lesser is the pressure. So here also, the weight of the bag may fall over a large area of the shoulder of the child, producing less pressure on the shoulder of the child, making it more comfortable to carry a heavy school bag on the shoulder. Is it clear? That is why we find a school bag has wide straps made up of thick cloth. Is it clear or not? One more application. If you observe the wheels of the army tanks, you will find a wide steel belt is provided over the wheels of the army tank. Why? A wide steel belt is provided over the wheels of the army tanks to have a larger area of contact with the ground. When you are having a belt around the wheels, the area of contact of the army tank is more on the ground. We have just understood that the area of contact and the pressure are inversely proportional to each other. Larger is the area of contact, lesser is the pressure. So here also, a heavy army tank exerts less pressure on the ground and do not sink into it. Is the concept clear to you? Now let us talk about animals like camels. If you observe the camels, which are called the sheep of the desert, they can walk easily in deserts as compared to horses or donkeys moving in the deserts. Why so? If you look at the camels, they have broad feet. What do they have? Broad feet. Broad feet exerts less pressure on the sandy ground. Why? Because we have just studied that pressure and area of contact are inversely proportional to each other. If the area of contact is more, the pressure exerted on the object is less. So here, because of broad feet, since the area of contact of the feet and the ground is more, the pressure exerted by the camel on the sand is lesser. That is why it does not sink into the sand of the desert. Is it clear or not? Let us now discuss about the pressure exerted by liquids. Till now, we have been discussing about pressure exerted by solids. Let us discuss about pressure exerted by liquids. All the liquids have weight. So when you pour a liquid into a vessel, for example, pouring water in a beaker, the weight of the liquid contained in the vessel exerts pressure where? The weight of the liquid contained in the vessel exerts pressure on its walls and also on the bottom. So where is the pressure exerted by the liquid when poured in a vessel? The liquid exerts pressure on the walls and the bottom of the vessel in which it is stored. What is this pressure called? Liquid pressure. Let us perform various activities to know about liquid pressure. Pressure exerted by liquids. The aim of the activity is to show that liquids exert pressure on the base of the container. What is the aim of the activity? To show that liquids exert pressure on the base of the container. What are the things needed to perform this activity? A transparent glass tube, rubber balloon, thread, and water. Let us begin this activity. Take a transparent glass tube, open at both ends. What you have taken? A transparent glass tube, open at both ends. To one end of the tube, tie a rubber balloon with the help of a thread. Now hold the tube in vertical position. Now hold the tube in vertical position and pour some water from the other end into this vessel. What you need now? Hold the tube in vertical position and pour some water into it. What do you observe? What are your observations? You observe that When you pour water into this glass tube, the rubber balloon bulges out. What happens? The rubber balloon bulges out. Now what you do? Pour some more water into the tube. What you will see? When you pour more water into the glass tube, you see that the size of the bulge increases. What you will see? The bulging of the rubber balloon increases. When it increases? When you pour more water into it. So what is the conclusion by looking at this activity? The liquid exerts pressure on the base of the container in which they are put. Because of the pressure exerted by the water on the rubber balloons, the rubber balloon gets bulged. So first conclusion is what? The liquid exerts pressure on the base of the container in which they are put. Number two, pressure exerted by water at the bottom of the container depends on what? The height of its column. More is the height of the column, more is the pressure. And lesser is the height of the column, lesser is the pressure. Why? Because on increasing the amount of water in the glass tube, we found more bulging of the rubber balloon. Why? Because by pouring more water, we found that the height of the column of the water is more in the glass tube. And that is why liquid pressure also increases. That is why more bulging of the rubber balloon takes place. Is the activity clear to you? This activity says two things. One, the liquid exerts pressure at the base of the container in which they are put. And number two, pressure exerted by water or any liquid at the bottom of the container depends on what? The height of the column. Let us do one more activity. The activity is to show that liquids exerts pressure on the walls of the container. So we need to show that liquids exerts pressure on the walls of the container. To perform this activity, the things needed are a glass tube with a side opening, rubber balloon, thread, and water. Let us begin this activity. We take a transparent glass tube with a tap-like opening on its side. So we have taken a glass tube with a side opening. Now tie a rubber balloon to the opening with the help of a thread. Hold the tube in the middle, keeping it in vertical position as you did in the previous activity. Pour some water into the glass tube. What you will observe? When you pour some water into the glass tube, you observe that the rubber balloon bulges outwards. Here it is sideways. So what do you observe here? You observe that the rubber balloon bulges outwards. Now pour some more water into the glass tube. What do you observe? When you pour more water into the glass tube, you will observe that the rubber balloon bulges more. So what is the conclusion of this activity? Here we find liquids exert pressure on the wall of the container. That is why the balloon has bulged out, because the water acts on the walls of the container also. So here, liquid exerts pressure on the walls of the container. Sideways pressure exerted by a liquid on the walls of the container is called its lateral pressure. What is lateral pressure of a liquid? Sideways pressure exerted by a liquid on the walls of the container is called its lateral pressure. Here we've seen the rubber balloon bulges more on adding more water. Why so? On adding more water, the depth of the water column increases. That is why the bulging of rubber balloon increases. This shows what? The lateral pressure increases with depth. So reason behind more bulging of the rubber balloon is because of what? Let us revise. The reason behind more bulging of rubber balloon is that the depth of the water column, the depth of the water column increases on adding more water. And hence, the pressure increases. This shows lateral pressure increases with depth. What is the important conclusion here? Lateral pressure increases with depth. More is the depth, more is the lateral pressure. We'll study various applications of lateral pressure in our next module. Let us quickly revise the main concepts of this module. What is pressure? Pressure is the force acting on a unit area of the object. Pressure P is equal to force F upon area A. Force acting per unit area of the object is called its pressure. What is the standard unit of measuring pressure? The standard unit of measuring pressure is Newton per square meter or Newton per meter square, which is also called Pascal. Pressure exerted by liquids is due to its own weight. Liquids exert pressure on the base of the container. Liquids exert pressure on the walls of the container. In other words, liquids exert pressure on the base of the container and on the walls of the container. I am sure all the concepts of this module are clear to you. Now let us answer all the questions given in the exercise based on this module in our notebook. I am sure if your concepts are clear, you will be able to answer all the questions easily, correctly, confidently, in your own words without cramming. So let us write all the answers to all the questions given in the exercise.